Hi guys, good evening. This is getting ridiculous because I have honestly lost count as to how many times I have tried to excuse me, to record this video and get it uploaded on YouTube and publish it and make it really public for everybody. But I could never bring myself to do it because I never really like the way it comes out. So hopefully, fingers crossed, this one will. The topic of this video is how to deal and how to cope with the loss of a loved one. And by loved one, I mean family member, friend, fur baby, anyone you can think of that's near and dear to us. We've all had losses. The older we get, the more likely it becomes that we experience losses in our lives. And I wish that, you know, by the time I started to experience losses, I wish I had known what I know now. And so I want to make this video primarily because I want to help other people who are maybe at the beginning of their grief journey, to help them understand a few things so that maybe it will help them cope a little bit better than I coped when I, you know, when I experienced a loss. So, just briefly, my name is Raluca. I am almost 55 years old, and I have had numerous losses in my life. Just to name a few, my mom died when I was about 22 years old. My dad died when I was about 30 and a half. My grandmother died when I was 29. And I had an aunt who died when I was almost 20 and a half. So, and I had friends, I had family, I had fur babies who died on me, and each and every one of those losses, even though it had its own grief journey, and every loss is different, every grief journey is different, but at the same time, there are certain aspects of a grief journey which, in my experience, are pretty much universal. Let me start by throwing a bombshell in here. Because a lot of people, I guess, when they're at the beginning of their grief journey, they will ask themselves, they will ask other people, they will ask, is this grief, is this pain ever going to end? The answer is no, it won't. The grief and the pain will never end. They will stay with you for the rest of your life. In time, they may diminish, and hopefully they will. In time, you learn to live with the loss. You learn to rearrange your life around the loss. You learn to cope and somehow incorporate the loss into a new sense of whatever normal means. but it never goes away completely. The pain will eventually dull down. It won't be as burning as at the beginning, maybe, but it will never go away, and it will resurface in at regular intervals. For example, when a deceased loved one has a birthday or a death anniversary or any other kind of special day that you connect with your lost loved one, you will always remember them. Maybe you will even cry for them. So the pain will always be there. And it just won't ever completely disappear. You know, people will say, oh, it's time to get back to normal. It's time to get back to normal. Well, think about it, folks. After a loved one dies, family member, friend, fur baby, anyone, things will never be the same as before the loss. So it's impossible to go back to normal, because things will never be normal again. So basically, you have to try to create a new normal in which the loss is a part of that new normal. It's not easy. It's not a quick process. Obviously, the length of time that you're grieving varies with each person, but it's not something that will go away overnight. It's something that will take a lot of time, and it will take a lot of mind work. And this is what this video hopefully will help you with the mind work. Because I have done a lot of mind work with every loss that I've experienced, with every grief journey that I've been through. I have learned a lot of things that I never knew before. Things that obviously I wish I'd never had to learn, but guys, once we're born, we're all on the way to wherever. For some people, it happens sooner. For some people, it happens later. But it will happen for everybody. So, and there are lessons to learn from losing loved ones. There are lessons to learn. And one of those lessons is that you can never, ever get over the loss of a loved one. It's just not possible. Because getting over it would mean that the deceased loved one would come back to Earth. And unfortunately, we all know that's not going to happen. So it's just silly, okay, to think that you're ever going to get over the loss of a loved one. Just like you won't ever heal from the loss of a loved one. I mean, healing would also mean that the deceased loved one comes back, and so the wound heals. It's not going to heal. What would happen is that the wound will eventually, in time, will close more and more and more and more, and there will be scar tissue where the gaping wound once was. There will be scar tissue that will still be there, but the wound is not going to be gaping anymore. That's what we can all hope for, and that's what we need to work towards with our grief journey. Again, like I said, it takes time. It's not going to happen overnight. And it's very important that we take the time it takes. For some people, it'll be quicker. For some people, it'll be slower. Grief is a very, very, very individual journey, a very private journey. Some people grieve outwardly. Some people grieve more for themselves. Some people show it. Some people don't. And it's very important, in my experience, it's very important for each and every one of us to find, to find the right way for us to grieve. There is no right or wrong way to grieve, but there is a right or wrong way for each individual. So whatever works for me may not work for you. Whatever works for you may not work for me. So you need to find your own individual way that's right for you. And if you find it, and when you find it, it will help you come to terms with the loss that you've suffered, and it will help you get some sort of closure. It will help you cope. It will help you go to a new kind of normal that is arranged around the loss that you've experienced. It's very, very, very important for everybody to find their own way. If you find your own way and you're comfortable with it and it helps you, then that is the right way for you. It may not be the right way for anybody else. It may not be the right way for your friends. It may not be the right way for other relatives. There are no two people who grieve exactly the same way. Even two siblings who would grieve the loss of their parents may grieve in totally different ways, and that's fine. That's wonderful. That's okay. Sometimes one sibling may have a better day. Sometimes the other sibling may have a better day. And you need to, if you want, I mean, if those siblings want to help each other, they need to basically get each other where they are at a certain time. You know, saying things like, oh, get over it, or you're grieving too much, or you're grieving too this or too that. It's absolutely the biggest bunch of BS. Okay? Because there is no right way to grieve and there is no wrong way to grieve. Grief is a journey taken by probably all of us eventually. But it's a very private, very individual journey. Now, another aspect of the grief journey is the feelings that you will find yourself facing. I never knew that grief comes with so many feelings. It's like absolutely mind-boggling. Okay, the first time that I had to deal with any kind of grief, I was sad 1 minute, I was angry the next minute, I was absolutely, desperate the next minute. And in between, I had moments where I was smiling and laughing because I was remembering funny things that the person I was grieving the loss of did or said. I mean, the feelings go from way underneath, lower than the basement, to all the way up high to whatever, the end of the universe. And they come and go sometimes at a pace where you cannot do anything to stop them or to suppress them or to make them go away or whatever. And let me tell you, folks, the worst thing that you can do is actually to try to suppress the feelings or to make them go away or to just, to swallow them or to bottle them up or to suppress them is probably the best way to... express this. Do not, and I cannot stress that enough, do not ever suppress whatever feelings come up. Because if you do that, then at some point or another, it may not be immediately, it may be tomorrow, next week, next month, next year, in 10 years, those feelings that you have, that you suppressed, are going to make their way to the surface. And it might be at the wrongest possible moment, when you don't want to have those feelings resurface and explode. And let me assure you that if you bottle those feelings up, they will explode at some point. You don't want that. So what you want to do is you want to let those feelings, whatever they are, let them go through you, experience them. Be mindful with them and really be in the moment with those feelings. If they are horrible feelings, if they are sad feelings, cry it out. If you remember something funny that you did with your deceased loved one, laugh about it, smile about it, and remember, be there with that feeling. Don't suppress it. Don't say, oh, I can't be feeling something like this. People who, for example, laugh because they just remembered something funny about their loved one. Oh my gosh, I'm not supposed to be laughing now. And they stop themselves from laughing. Don't do that. Because those feelings are going to come through you. And if you suppress them, it's going to make you feel a lot worse. Trust me. I've been there. For people who want to help a bereaved person, I mean, what you can do is go to your friend or family member who is a bereaved person, ask them, is there anything I can do for you? Maybe there is. Maybe they would like you to go get something from the store. Maybe they would like to talk to you about this. Maybe they would like to share things with you. Let them. Maybe they just want you to be there in the same room with them. Then be in the same room with them. You don't even need to say anything. You don't even need to say anything. Just being there with that other person will probably help them a lot more than you will ever know. Because just being there with somebody, being there for somebody, shows the other person that you feel with them, that you're there for them, and that you want to help them. Grief is a very, very private, very personal experience. And it doesn't matter how long or how short you grieve. It doesn't matter if you grieve openly or if you grieve just for yourself. It doesn't matter if you show it or if you don't show it. Neither one of those aspects, openly or not, showing or not, public or private, neither one of those has anything to do with how much you loved the person you lost. It doesn't. Because we all grieve differently, folks. We all grieve differently. We all have different experiences with the people we lose, with the loved ones we lose. So, of course, our grief will be different. What I'm thinking is I would like to get into a journey with you guys, my followers, people who are watching this video. And the way I think would probably be the best way is if you leave comments or experiences or questions down below in the comments. If you leave questions or comments or anything like that, then I can either make a new video answering the questions, or I can answer them in the comments. That's probably a good idea. Tell me in the comments, what you would like to know, maybe a little more specific about grief or about the grief journey. You can ask me specific questions, and I will try my hardest to give you an answer that you can work with. Obviously, I don't know. I don't know anybody out there who might comment on this video. But if you give me a story, if you give me, you know, if you ask me any questions, I will certainly try my hardest to answer them. If you are right now at the beginning of your grief journey, if you have recently lost somebody you loved, let me tell you, I'm very, very, very sorry. I am very sorry for your loss, and please accept my heartfelt condolences. If you are further ahead in your grief journey, like I am, Again, I'm sorry that you experienced your loss, and I hope that you have found a way to cope and to deal with it, and to remember your loved ones the way they would like you to remember them. Life has to go on, my friends. Life really has to go on, even after we experience a loss. But maybe it'll help if you think that your loved ones, your friends, your fur babies, whoever it is, are still with you in spirit, in memory. They will make their way into your thoughts when you least expect them. It has happened to me, and it can happen to you too. I'm hoping that I was able to ease your way a little bit into the grief journey. I realize it's only superficial, what I've been talking about right now. But if you guys want, if you guys are interested in sharing your grief, in maybe going on part of the grief journey together with me and with other people, then, like I said, ask me questions, share your story in the comments below, and I will do my best to get through those questions, to write them down maybe, and like I said, either answer them in the comments or make a new video, sort of like a Q&A video. If you guys want to see a Q&A video, that's fine. Just leave me a few questions, and then maybe I will do a Q&A video next time. For right now, I believe that that's probably as much as I'm going to talk about right now. But I want each and every one of you to take a moment, close your eyes, think about your loved ones that you lost, and be grateful that you had them at all. Because grief is the price that we pay for loving another human being or a fur baby. And think about how sad it would be if we didn't love anybody and if nobody loved us. And with that, I wish you all a very happy and peaceful night. Let's all pray for all the fallen veterans tomorrow, Memorial Day. Actually, it's today because it's after midnight. So today, a Memorial Day. Let us all think about the fallen veterans. May they all rest in peace. And we thank them for their service. I love you guys, and I hope to see you soon. And like I said, leave me comments in the comments below. I love you guys. God bless. Bye-bye.